Hey guys, we are talking about e-technologies in this chapter. So what is e-technology? E-technology is basically electronic technology under which all the steps that are related with the internet and digital devices can. So this is an important topic and very easy topic as regard with the UGC NET examinations because from this chapter, that is e-technology, the direct theoretical questions are asked. Okay, so let's start. The first one is electronic commerce. So what is e-commerce? E-commerce websites are generally, or e-commerce is generally a platform where with the use of digital communication and internet and the digital devices, the business is happen. Okay, or to do business or to sell the products with the use of digital communication, digital devices and internet, how to sell product and how to do business is generally come across or termed as electronic commerce. The second is history of e-commerce, generally how e-commerce is came across, how the word e-commerce came across. So it came across from the word EDI, that is electronic data interchange. EDI is performed as electronic data interchange. So from electronic data interchange, where the invoices are sent, all the products invoices are sent up between the seller and the customer. So from that point EDI, the word e-commerce has come. So why I am mentioning EDI more and more? Because the question that asked one time in our previous NET examination is the abbreviation of EDI. So the correct is electronic data interchange. Now the second is types of e-commerce. That's important. There are basically five types of e-commerce. The first is B2C, or you can call as business to consumer or business to customers, which is generally termed as how to sell product online from a company specific to the individual. Okay, it's come across or termed as B2C. For example, if you have just ordered a mobile phone, then you are individual, and suppose you have ordered this mobile phone from any e-commerce website, whether it's Amazon or Flipkart. So it's a type of B2C e-commerce. The second is B2B, means business to business, in which the large multinational companies or the companies and between retail shoppers are came, where business to business e-commerce is. Okay. The third one is C2C, means consumer to consumer or customer to customer. For example, eBay, where consumer to consumer e-commerce is happening, where the user or the seller is also consumer of that product and purchaser or the customer is also consumer of that product. The next one is P2P or peer to peer. It's the type of e-commerce where the services or the business which do not make happen in general business are also came across. For example, billing and like that examples. The next one is m-commerce, where how to do this all that stuff with the mobile phones. Okay, so all the services to do with the mobile phones are generally termed as m-commerce. Now B2C is common type of e-commerce, and business to business is the largest type of e-commerce. So it's the largest type of e-commerce and it's a common type of e-commerce, and it's the largest, means basically the, if you will see that 60-70% of e-commerce are between B2B type, between multinational companies and core companies or the local companies like that. The next is application of e-commerce. E-tailing, procurement and auction sites. E-tailing is basically sell out product online. Procurement is also selling out the product, but it generally termed as between how to sell out the product with the help of the next users also. Means by making a subsidiary companies, means you to sell out to the different companies and they will distribute among the different users like that. And then auction sites are there, where are many websites are there and online products are sell out on that. The next is advantages. So advantages of e-commerce is reduced prices. They have reduced the prices global market means if a ruler, there is a user from rural area, then he can also order from, he can also order directly to the purchaser or the seller. So global market is there, and he can also means the all countries, or you can also order from America or Canada like that. So there is a common global market of business is there. So it's the advantages of e-technology. The next is quick delivery is there, and less travel work at home means you need not to be travel all around market and waste your energy. You just sit out at your home and you can just order by pressing some keys. Okay, now there are some disadvantages as well. For example, hidden cost are some in some products there is a hidden cost which we generally can't find out very easily. And network unreliability is there, means many times if you have ordered, so due to network fidelity or network traffic, you can't find out the exact product or about inquiry about that product. So these are basically disadvantages, but if you see advantages are more. So this is basically e-technology. In our next videos of e-technology, we will cover out the remaining portion of e-technology, and we will also discuss some important questions that have asked in our previous examination of NET. So guys, please subscribe our channel so that you can't miss out any important video and you can score very well in your examination. Guys, also press the bell icon button so that you can get the instant notification from our side. And this is a specifically video course for the UGC NET examination. So please subscribe our channel, and if you have any kind of query, you can comment us. We will solve your query as early as possible. Thank you so much.